안녕 친구. Today we're in Busan, the second most populated South Korean city after Seoul. Upon a walk around Haeundae Beach, we get street food. The star of the show is seafood. Alright, the night is young. Not too many people out and about eating just yet. We have a couple stalls that sells fresh seafood. And I turn around and there are more stalls selling fresh seafood. Oh, so many options. More fresh seafood! More! Okay, so I'm looking at all the stalls and they're all pretty much the same, even the menu. These stalls look like clones. I guess I'll just choose one that's pretty empty and quiet, so that way I could vlog peacefully without worrying about disturbing neighboring diners. So we're gonna be sitting right here on the little zoo of animals. All of these, they serve raw.
Bubbles overflowing from the tank's edge remind me of beer foam. In Korean, these guys are called kebul, translated as the fat innkeeper's worm.
So I was trying to choose a place where the lady is friendly, but this lady is a little bit grumpy, to be honest. But it's okay, we're gonna make the best of it. And she's giving me a little deal because I'm dining alone. She will give me two kinds for 30,000 won. And right next to me, you have a drama playing. Okay, I'm gonna migrate because this drama might create some background noise. There are pictures of the lady who works here and a bunch of celebrities. But here, she doesn't look that grumpy at all. I'm looking inside this tent, and check it out, the ceiling. It is covered in business cards all over. Check it out. Oh, 감사합니다.
On the left, we have sora, turban shell. The right is haesam, sea cucumber. The gradients of the sea cucumber remind me of a human iris. The bumps look like pimples, alien pimples.
We've also got some cabbage, tomatoes, cucumber, as well as tangerines. This is samjang, and ooh, this one is sesame oil with salt, and I smell that. 감사합니다.
This liquidy red sauce is chojang, and it contains chili pepper.
The lady was telling me, originally you're supposed to stick it into the chojang. You could stick in any other sauce though. That is a very firm texture. You know what? We should try one as is by itself without any additional sauce. Oh, now that bite was softer. This time, let's dip it with the sesame and salt. I have a bias towards sesame oil, so that sesame oil, tastes really good with that.
The vendor got a fresh batch of what looks to be sora.
So if you have it as is by itself without anything, mostly it is bland. There are moments of bitterness.
아침에 내가 안 보고 나갔네.
20% bitter. Oh, look at this one. This is like the odd one out. Oh wow, that's like the most firm part. Wow, that's a warrior. Oh, it's like a muscular. You really need to fight with that one. It's wrestling. Okay, now let's try the sea cucumber. It looks like the galaxy, but will it taste like the galaxy? Well, that one's salty. It's more tough. Over time, it gets a little bit more slimy and soft, while that saltiness lingers. Now, this time, let's try it with the samjang. As expected, sweet, spicy, salty. Of all the sauces here, I'm preferring the sesame oil with salt. That's all based on personal preference. I got a really nice view of this TV. I'm watching this drama, and this girl just fainted on her bed. The sun has set. The lady working here, she got a little bit nicer. My meal is tasting just a tad more delicious now. I can't get over how gross yet cool this texture and these colors are. The sesame oil somewhat kills the saltiness. The sea cucumber has more of an ocean flavor. This time we'll have it with the chojang. With the sea conch, you could bite it completely and then swallow it. Oh, that was a really bitter one. With a sea cucumber, no matter how many times you chew on it, it's still slimy and there's still pieces that you want to keep chewing on it, but then you stop chewing on it and you just swallow because you're just like, this is gonna go on forever. In many eating situations in Busan, especially when it comes to seafood, it's good to have an eating buddy. One dish is 20,000 won, but if you eat with multiple people, you get to order more variety and try different things. And not to mention, you could order soju and beer. This lady is called Yokjingi Imo, and she is cursing to her customers. I guess that's her thing. It all makes sense why she was a little bit like kind of grumpy to me earlier.
I asked the vendor about the hours of operation. Generally, the stalls open around 5 p.m. Some close at midnight, while others serve customers until morning. The stalls as a collective have been in business for over 10 years.
I didn't think I could do it, but I did it. Done. I'm actually not big on seafood, but I know some of you guys out there who are watching my videos, some of you may be big seafood fans, so I wanted to show you this place. Alright, so I'm gonna be paying her 30,000 won. I'm still a little bit hungry, so let's look around. These guys, you take it and you suck on it. So I'm very curious about this. It looks like they have fries on the outside of this corn dog. And I know Busan is all about the seafood, but come on, if you're curious, you're curious. All right, so it looks like we could take a seat right here. Oh, look at that texture. So much grittiness. French fries are crunchy. The skin is thick and spongy. And of course, we have the sausage in the middle.
The thick skin dilutes the flavor of the sausage. The ketchup is an alternative to lipstick.
And we got a cup of... That was a soup in which the fish cakes are dunked in. Overall, I found the Busan locals to be quite friendly, but there's always an exception. And you know what? It's easy for me to judge and say, oh, those ladies were grumpy. But I don't know their story. Maybe they just had a bad day or previously a bad experience of something. I don't know. Who knows? Regardless, I'm just giving you an honest review of my experience. And now I am walking back to my accommodation. Last time I was in Busan, I only got to check out a bit of Dongdaekseom. Today we're gonna check out another route. In the previous trip, we started from the beach, and then we made a round, and then we ended up here. This time we're gonna start from where we ended last time, and let's go through the promenade and go to the APEC house. Earlier in the day, it was warm and sunny, but it's past 6 p.m., so it's cooled down.
You can barely hear the city noises, and you do hear the birds chirping. They're actually quite talkative. We just made it to the APEC, but it looks like they are closed, so we'll just admire the fencing. Right, the opening time is 9 a.m. to 6 p.m., regular closure the first Monday of every month. Oh, that mist in the distance is giving me so much feels. Right now we are approaching the lighthouse. I'm trying to figure out what the shape is. It kind of looks like a broccoli. Alright, so we are here. If we look straight, there is Tsushima Island. Well, it's a bit foggy, so we can't really see. Just use your imagination. It's over there. Alas, the ever-increasing skyline of Haeundae Beach. Skyscrapers inch closer to the clouds as the shore's width slims down due to the ocean's current. We approach women stretching their calves. And yet more fishermen!
Last time I was in Busan, it was in autumn, and there was a ton of like these fast bugs scurrying on this path.
But today I am seeing none of them. What is this? Looks like we're gonna have to make a detour.
Okay, instead we're gonna have to climb up these stairs. There's a sudden smell of freshly cut wood. And then all of a sudden it smells like rotten broccoli. I don't know how that transition happened so fast.
This is where we began, and we took the route to the right, and then we circled all the way back around.
We're gonna go through Joseon Hotel to get to the beach. I After you walk on the beach and your feet and shoes get all sandy, you could use this device. And then it'll help get the sand out. We're approaching a busking zone. Oh look, what do you know? It's the same gentleman who played last time we were at Haeundae Beach. Oh, it's like Jekyll and Hyde face, half and half. So I picked up 100 grams of almonds.
Do you like the painting behind me? It has unicorns, snowflakes, and watermelon slices.
I hope you guys enjoyed eating with me and just taking a stroll at Dongbaekseom. Remember to hit that subscribe button if you haven't already. And I'll see you guys in the next travel video. 안녕! I'm still waiting for my laundry to dry. And look, what's this? It's one of my shirts. Wanna see more food and travel videos from me? Be sure to check out my other channel, Miss Mina Oh, for adventures beyond Korea. 안녕!